What's up? I'm gonna do a different one here, but I do this shit all the time, and so I might as well record it while I watch it. Y'all can do it with me if you like. Let's go. Oh shit, what's wrong?
Just, you know, pivoting within the game, you know, making a slight adjustment. Wanted to take A off as being the initial line of defense, and hopefully, you know, Rui could turn him, make him go east-west a little bit more. And once he went up to shoot, you know, he shoots 70% on those floaters, those little short-range chip shots and floaters and hooks and little one-leg fadeaways. He shoots them at an amazing rate, scores them, I should say. So just the idea was just to get A behind him a little bit and have A as that big long arm just ready to contest over the top of Rui. And so it was good for us in some segments. And, you know, we were able to, after a tough first half, giving up 72 points, claw our way back into it. I think the closest we got was within three. But, you know, hats off to them. They came out, they defended their home floor.
Usually do this. On LeBron, 39-9 in the closeout game, 43 minutes. 18th 30-point game in a series-clinching win. That's one shy of tying Michael Jordan for most all-time. 41st series win, most all-time. He is 10-1. This will be his 12th conference finals. He's 10-1 in conference finals. His own. Couple big things that I think happened in that second half. Number one, putting Hachimura in that fourth quarter onto Nikola Jokic, which allowed Anthony Davis to essentially be a roamer. And it's interesting because we saw this adjustment from Darvin Ham in terms of the matchup with Anthony Davis in that Golden State series. When Steph was having success in game five against Anthony Davis in the pick and roll when he was guarding Gary Payton, they put him on Wiggins. Golden State went away from that. At times in game six, depending on who was on the court, Davis would be in the pick and roll. Then he would not be in the pick and roll. And I think what's clear is Nikola Jokic, no offense to Anthony Davis, no offense to DeAndre Ayton, no offense to Rudy Gobert, no offense to really anyone in the league, but he's unstoppable. And so by putting Anthony Davis off the ball and by putting him on Aaron Gordon, he's able to roam and be a help defender and contest late. We saw that a couple times where he's just getting into the mud with Jokic as he gets deeper against Hachimura. So that's going to be something interesting. What does Michael Malone do with Aaron Gordon. I know tonight he put him in the dunker spot. Can I just say one thing real quick? I was texting our boy Ryan Cohen. Big fan of the show. We talk about Ryan all the time. And I hate the dunker spot. I absolutely hate the dunker spot. And no, I don't mean the podcast. I mean the physical location of Anthony Davis on Aaron Gordon. And I would expect that to me, or just play him as the pick and roll guy, space Jokic. That to me is something that I think Michael Malone will have to adjust. If they're going to put Anthony Davis on Aaron Gordon, and I would expect, I would expect this. I'm not saying it's going to happen. I would expect Hachimura to start for D'Angelo Russell. I think Schroeder starts with Austin. And Reeves, they go bigger, they put Hachimura and LeBron James and Anthony Davis in the front court, gives them a little more versatility. It's going to be asking a little bit more of LeBron James against that starting unit to have to guard probably Michael Porter Jr. off the ball. That's a little bit more. But if you're going to put Anthony Davis on Aaron Gordon, have him be the screener and pick and roll with Jamal Murray, if Jokic is going to post, have him spaced out, throw the ball to him, have him go DHO with Michael Porter Jr. Have him go DHO.
Something that we just went to, a little adjustment. Different adjustment just throughout the course of the game. We did end up, liking it, stayed with it for a while. Maybe something we go to game two. Obviously, we got to go back and look at the film. But just thinking about it right now, something that we like, just to also have me, roaming and things like that. So, good adjustment, but like I said, we'll go back in and figure out a way we can be better.
In LeBron, just what did you notice about the way Denver hit first? What was the key on the glass and Jokic and everything, and how did you guys find a way to adjust over the course of the game?
Yeah, I mean, it took us a half the end of the game, and that was pretty much the ball game right there. We got to understand that, we got to start from the tip-off, they punched us in the mouth to start. I think they had more offensive rebounds than we had total rebounds in the first half. And, that led to them getting second chance points. They also got on the fast break and killed us in the fast break in the first half, and was 10 for 10 from the free throw line. So, I know the game is won in 48 minutes, but they set the tone in 24 minutes, and, we was playing catch up for the next 24.
Thanks. I haven't been through so many of these before. How do you feel like the team's going to be affected by cutting the margin down to three like you did tonight, going
in postseason, it doesn't matter if you cut it to one or you're down 20. If you lose, you lose. They're 1-0, and we have to come back with desperation going into game two. We have to play better. We have to rebound better. I thought we did a good job of not turning the ball over. That's one thing we've been very conscious about in the postseason. But we've been better in transition tonight. We wasn't that great in the first half. We cleaned it up in the second half. So we need to be better at all facets of the game. No, just kind of reading the game. It's a game, always a game in between the game, and just reading the game and making the proper reads. You know, they started to go to a 3-4-5 switch and pick and rolls. Where anytime I was involved with AD, they started to switch, you know, Joker onto me, and trying to keep a body on body because AD was doing a great job of getting into that pocket and doing what he does best with his floaters and you know, things of that nature. So we have opportunities, and we know we can go to other things that that also can work for us with, you know, myself handling the ball with guards, set pick a roll, trying to get a good matchup, seeing how they're going to play, if they're going to switch or if they're going to hard show or whatever the case may be. And we just try to exploit that and allow AR to get going in the fourth.
I think AR is going to be a low-key gym, but he can't guard Michael J. Porter. He's too short, man. Michael J. Porter is a beast. I'm curious to see if they'll ever put Anthony Davis on Michael Porter. I don't think it's smart because he plays so wide out. Or they need to put Vanderbilt on Michael Porter, and then AD on AG. Rui should stay on. I think Rui just played really well on Joker, and then Joker stopped trying. But they need to figure out how to do that. This is going to be a fun series. I don't think, like, even though they're up by 20, I don't think it was really that bad of a 20. You could really feel it. But I'm curious to see what happens next. Let me know if you guys like these type of videos of, fucking, like, the interviews and shit. Because I watch this shit regardless, yeah. And I was just like, fuck it, I might as well record. But if you don't like it, it's good. If you do, cool. Deuce.